The same place, the same view, but something is missing. And that is because he who is eternal has now dissolved back into eternity. For decades, he was with us and moved very much amongst us. He came to us. He took letters from us. He talked to us. And he moved so freely amongst us. He delivered so many discourses to us. And he celebrated so many festivals with us. He became so much a part of our lives that we simply could not imagine being without his physical form. However, when God comes in human form, he too bows to time, since that is the dharma of the body, avatars dawn. The Lord came as Rama, fulfilled his mission, and then went back. Krishna came, gave his message, which was the most important part of his incarnation, and he too withdrew. In this Kali age, the Lord came again, first as Shirdi Baba. And once his mission was over, he too withdrew from the form. He came again, as he said he would, as Sathya Sai Baba. But inevitably, when the time came, Swami also withdrew from the form, as the Lord always does. Swami always led a very active life. But during the last few years, he slowed down. Yet he obliged, for example, by visiting a few places.
Shubh
As always, he was very considerate to the devotees, but it was clear he was easily getting tired. This was particularly evident as the year 2011 dawned. Darshans now became somewhat irregular. And then came March 2011. March 20th, it was a Sunday and there was a huge crowd. Swami stayed a long time that evening and showered abundant blessings on students. Everyone was happy, for it had been a wonderful darshan. Friday, March 25th. Swami came, though a bit late. He did not stay long, but everyone understood he was tired. That was the last darshan Swami gave in the Sai Kolwant Hall. The Swami as we all knew him and loved would not be seen anymore. But none was aware of it then. Saturday, March 26th. Devotees waited, but Swami did not come for darshan. That afternoon, Swami was taken to the super speciality hospital. This was the very hospital he had built for the poor. That was 20 years ago. Over the years, thousands and thousands of poor people got their lives back in this hospital. This was the hospital Swami had visited many times and for many purposes. But this time, Swami came to the hospital as a patient. The news spread, and there was anxiety everywhere. In the hospital, Swami was taken to the catheterization lab and fitted with a pacemaker. Following that, Swami was moved into intensive care. The news was that Swami was doing fine, and there was naturally a sigh of relief. Everyone was confident that Swami would be back in Yajur Mandir within a few days, and that darshans would resume after Swami had a little rest. Sadly, that did not happen, and Swami's stay in the hospital continued. And then the bulletins started coming. that was when everyone began to pray. Normally, devotees pray to Swami for themselves, but this time, they prayed to Him, for Him, all over the world. In the village of Puttaparthi too, there was deep concern. For the villagers, Swami was their very own. After all, was not Swami born there? Though Swami stayed in Puttaparthi, He hardly went out into the village. On the few occasions he did, he was always greeted with great enthusiasm, especially when he returned after a trip. When Swami was in the hospital, the residents of Puttaparthi too held their vigils. April 24th, Easter Sunday. The time was 7:40 a.m. The hospital issued its last bulletin. What everyone believed would not ever happen and could not happen, actually had. Sadly, facts or empirical reality has to be accepted, and all of us who have been left behind now had to move on. p.m. Swami went from Yajur Mandir to the Sai Kulwant Hall for the last time. Not the way he used to, but in a way that shook all devotees to their very roots. Huge crowds had gathered, and suddenly, for those who were attending closely on Swami for nearly a month, the most important issue was making sure that everyone had a chance to file past and pay their respects.
koti pranam, shat koti pranam, he dinanath saira.
Swami being a national and indeed a global figure, there was a great clamor that the very last darshan of Swami ought to be brought to people everywhere via television. Hurriedly, arrangements for this were also made. Puttaparthi is used to huge crowds, especially at birthday times. But this was different. The crowd this time was made up of people who wanted one last precious glimpse that would forever be etched in their memory. The crowd that one saw from the evening of Sunday, April 24th to midday of Wednesday, April 27th were unparalleled, even for Puttaparthi. Earlier, during darshan, Swami would slowly move all over the hall, coming close to devotees. But now, it was different. Swami stayed where he was, and devotees had to go close to him to have darshan. Swami loved all without exception. And for their part, devotees too loved Swami in a thousand different ways. However, when they stood for a fleeting second near the casket, there was only one emotion: deep anguish. And grief found a thousand ways to express itself. The crowds were massive and poured in non-stop from all over the country. However, everyone waited patiently for his or her turn. And this long wait also gave the villagers the chance to rise to their highest level of hospitality. The service that the people of Puttaparthi rendered was spontaneous. For them, this was the best way of seeing Swami, through service to those who had come from far and wide.
Sai Ram, Sai Ram.
They all came, from the humblest and the lowliest, to rich and the famous. For Swami loved all without any distinction. Incidentally, bhajan singing went on non-stop all the time. Day after day, something no one can remember ever happening before.
तुमसे प्यार कितना सा
Approach for saying the final goodbye.
Our most beloved Bhagavan, respected all religions, Sai represents fellowship of faiths and unity of religions. On this occasion, we have eminent personalities representing different religions who will render a few verses from the respective scriptures of their faiths.
Prayer from Judaism.
Adon Olam Asher Malak Beterem Kol Ezir Nibrak Leet Nasak Keheb Sokol Azai Melek Shemonikra.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Wat-tini waz-zaytuni wat-tur-sinin wa hazal baladil amin. لقد خلقنا الإنسان في أحسن تقويم ثم رددناه أسفل سافلين.
श्री सत्य साई बाबा जी ने पूरी दुनिया के अंदर सत्य पर सच्चाई पर जो काम किया इसी तरह से सभी लोग अच्छी उनकी बातों को बताई हुई बातों के मुताबिक चलें। हम सबको पूरे इस्लाम की तरफ से श्री सत्य बाबा साईं बाबा जी को खराज अकीदत पेश करते हैं। वस्सलाम वालेकुम।
Jai Sri Sathya Sai Baba Ji, Jai Hind.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
हे अकाल पुरख वाहेगुरु जी, आप दे चरना चरदास बेनती है। पवन में पवन समाया, ज्योति में ज्योत रल जाया। साहिबां दे हुक्म अनुसार श्री सत्या साई बाबा जी पंच तत्व शरीर की यात्रा संपूर्ण करके ब्रह्म लीन होए हन। निरंकार वाहेगुरु जी राम जी उन्हां दी उन्हां नूं अपने विच अगमता प्रदान करो जी, ਅਤੇ ਸਰਬੱਤ ਭਗਤਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਭਾਣਾ ਮੰਨਣ ਦੀ ਸਮਰੱਥਾ ਪ੍ਰਦਾਨ ਕਰੋ ਜੀ। ਬਖਸ਼ਾਂ ਮਿਹਰਾਂ ਕਰਨੀਆਂ ਸਹੀ ਗੁਰਮੁਖ ਪਿਆਰੇ ਮੇਲ ਨੇ, ਜਿਨ੍ਹਾਂ ਮਿਲਿਆ ਆਪ ਜੀ ਦਾ ਨਾਮ ਚੇਤੇ ਆਵੇ। ਨਾਨਕ ਨਾਮ ਚੜ੍ਹਦੀ ਕਲਾ, ਤੇਰੇ ਭਾਣੇ ਸਰਬੱਤ ਦਾ ਭਲਾ। ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕਾ ਖਾਲਸਾ, ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕੀ ਫਤਿਹ। ਬੋਲੇ ਸੋਨਿਹਾਲ ਸ੍ਰੀ ਅਕਾਲ। ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕਾ ਖਾਲਸਾ, ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕੀ ਫਤਿਹ। ਬੈਠੋ ਜੀ ਸਾਰੇ।
ਓਮ ਸਾਈਸ਼ਵਰਾਯ ਵਿਦਮਹੇ सत्यदेवाय धीमहि तन्नः सर्व प्रचोदयात्। ॐ साईश्वराय।
Slowly and with great respect, the casket was moved to the veranda for the family members to offer their prayers.
सर्व प्रचोदयात्। ॐ साईश्वराय विद्महे सत्यदेवाय धीमहि तन्नः सर्व प्रचोदयात्।
And then the curtain came down.
ॐ साईश्वराय विद्महे।
Yes, the curtain had come down on an era where we all live deeply attached to the form. Soon, that curtain would rise again to mark the beginning of an era where we would be strongly tested. That difficult test would start soon. As we look around, little has changed. The same hall, the same decoration, and the same crowd. And yet, there has been a dramatic change.
Satya Devaya Dhimahi.
After a tense half an hour, the curtain finally went up.
Om Sai Ishwaraya Vidmahe Satya Devaya Dhimahi Tannas Sarva Prachodayat. Om.
From now on, we have to go into the future, anchored to memories of the past, for the form had transcended to the realm of the formless.
Tannas Sarva Prachodayat.
Even the casket has gone, making the beautiful form of Swami strictly a matter of memory and feeling.
Devaya Dhimahi Tannas Sarva Prachodayat.
In a series of discourses on the Bhagavad Gita, delivered in 1984, Swami said, "You are all here in this hall, and Swami also is in this hall. But when you go back to your village, you would see no hall and no Swami speaking. However, if you look inside, you would see it all." What is true of the senses is also true of love. Yes, this is how all devotees experienced pure love then. But that love has not vanished altogether, for it now plays in our hearts. We can always experience that love. All we need to do is to open our hearts. Swami, in his formless aspect, is eternal and always is. But Swami, with the wonderful form we all loved, was but a sample of the eternal bliss that God is. That eternal bliss is not lost and can never be. In fact, there is a simple way to experience it.
Din dukhiyon se prem karo mera sai prasand ho.
Is always transient, but the love of Swami is forever.
Prem Ishwar hai, Ishwar prem hai. Ishwar hai.